In this video, we will implement BAT algorithm using Python. BAT algorithm, that is a nature-inspired optimization algorithm developed by Wang in 2010. This algorithm is based on the echolocation behavior of bats. Bats use echolocation to detect prey, avoid obstacles, and navigate in dark. So this algorithm simulates this behavior to find out the optimal solution for the complex optimization problems. So about this algorithm, we already discussed in previous video, even using numerical example. Now we will implement this algorithm using Python. So BAT algorithm key concept used in this algorithm: echolocation, that bat emit a sound wave that bounce back after hitting an object. By analyzing the time delay and frequency of the returning echoes, bats can determine the location and the size of the prey. Next, we have frequency and the loudness. So in this algorithm, each bat represents a potential solution, and bats adjust their frequency and loudness as they search for the optimal solution. And the loudness decreases as bat gets closer to the target and pulse emission rate increases. Then we have velocity and the position update. So the algorithm update each bat position and velocity based on its current position, velocity, frequency, and a randomly chosen solution. So the position update is guided by the best solution found so far. Then we have the local search that is used to refine the search. So algorithm introduced the local search mechanism where bats make a small adjustment to their position based on the random factors and the average loudness of all bats. So first we initialize the position. We have a population of the bats, and each bat is here a potential solution with a random position. So randomly initialize the position and velocity. Second, we will update the position and velocity. After that, we'll perform local search. Then selection is performed. So algorithm select the best solution based on the objective function values. And this process will continue until the stopping condition is met, such as the maximum number of iteration. So now step by step, we will implement this algorithm. So you can use here any objective function. For the simplicity, we are using here the sphere function as the objective function, that is a common test function used for the optimization algorithms. After that, we'll initialize the parameters. Parameter values that we are using here: number of bats, that is the population size, suppose we have 20, dimension we have 5, lower bound minus 10, upper bound is 10, and maximum number of iteration we are using here 1000. So we imported numpy as np. Now we will define the objective function. So we are using here the sphere function for simplicity. So define objective function, that it will return a value. After that, we will initialize the bat population. So here we will create a function, initialize bats. Inside this we have the parameter: population size, dimension, lower bound, upper bound, minimum frequency, maximum frequency, loudness, and pulse rate. After that, we'll randomly initialize the bat position in the search space. So here we will np.random.uniform. So values are uniformly distributed within 0 and 1. That is lower bound, upper bound. Then we have number of bats and the dimension. Dimension we are using here 5, lower bound, upper bound. So we need all the bats within the bound. After that, we will initialize the velocities for each bat, that is np.0s, number of bats, and for all dimension. Then we will initialize the frequencies for each bat. Randomly initialize the frequency, so np.random.uniform, then minimum frequency, maximum frequency, and the number of bats. After that, initialize the pulse rate. Here we are using here r0 into np.1s, number of bats. After that, initialize the loudness, a0 into np.1s, and the bats. So here this function will return bats, their velocities, frequencies, pulse rates, and the loudness. After this, we will update the position and the velocity for each bat. So here We just initialize the initial velocity and the position. Now we will update the position and velocity. So in order to update velocity, we are using here this equation. So we will create a function here, update position and velocity. Inside this we have watts, velocities, frequency, best watt, lower bound, upper bound. Then for velocity, we are using this equation. So here we are using this equation to update velocity for each watt. After that, when the velocity is updated, we will update the position. So we will add the velocity in the previous position using this. After that, we will check the boundary. So we will now check whether the new position that we updated for the watt, it is within the boundary or not. Boundary we have lower bound, upper bound, all solution need to be satisfied. So here we will clip np.clip watts, lower bound, upper bound, that will return the watts and the velocities. Now we will perform the local search. So again, we will define a function here for the local search for each watt, best watt, and the average loudness. So here we are using this equation. So the value for this we have within minus 1 and 1. So for each watt, perform the local search. So using this equation, so here we will write this equation and perform the local search. After that, we will start the main loop for this algorithm. Here define another function that will calculate the best value for watt, that is the optimal value. So we have watt algorithm. Inside this, all the parameters, number of watts, dimension, lower bound, upper bound, maximum iteration, minimum frequency we are taking here 0, maximum frequency we are taking here 100, then alpha we have 0.9, gamma 0.9, loudness 1, pulse rate 0.5. After that, we will initialize the watts. So here already we defined the function for the watts to initialize the watt population. Now we will call this function here, and then we will initialize the watt population. So watt, velocities, frequency, pulse rate, loudness. We are calling this function here, number of watt, dimension, and write all the parameters inside it. After that, now the position is initialized. Now for each watt position, we calculate its fitness value. So use the objective function here to calculate the fitness value. Now fitness is equal to np.array. Apply objective function on each watt for watt in watts. Done. Now best watt is the watt that having the minimum value, that is the minimum fitness value among all. That is the minimum fitness value. So best fitness is the np.minimum fitness. After that, we will start the loop here. After that, you can see the pseudo code we will generate. Now we will generate new solution by adjusting frequency. Then we will update it. Select the solution and perform all. Now we will do this process. So here for maximum iteration, we'll repeat this loop. Now start the loop here for I in range up to number of watt. Now we'll generate a new solution. So here we will generate the new solution using update. So here we already created a function, update position and velocity before. So we are calling this function here, watts and velocity, that we will calculate using this function. As you can see here, using this function, we are calculating the new position and the velocity for each watt. Done. So here using this function, we will update the position, velocity. After that, we will compare the pulse rate and loudness with the random values. Here we are taking any random number. Rand is here any random number between 0 and 1. So we will check if this random number is greater than the pulse rate. Then we will perform the local search, else we will consider new watt as that watt. Here for each watt we have 20 watt. So value for I we have 1 to 20. So for each watt we will perform the comparison. So here if the condition is true, perform the local search. So average loudness, now calculate the average loudness, that is np.mean loudness. Then new watt is equal to local search. Here we are calling this function local search, watt, best watt and average loudness. Else we will consider the new watt as the as that VAT. Then we will calculate new fitness value for the newly generated solution using objective function. Calculate now the fitness value. After that, we will compare the loudness. So here we check the pulse rate. Now we'll check the VAT loudness. So we will use here any random number np.random.rand, that it is less than loudness of that VAT, and we will also check the new fitness value, whether it is less than the previous value or not. If the newly generated fitness value is better, then we will consider this as older one. So if this condition is true, we will accept the new solution. So here VAT I, that is VAT I is equal to the new VAT, and fitness of this VAT is equal to new fitness, and loudness of this VAT is calculated using this equation. After that, pulse rate of this VAT is calculated using this equation. Now we will compare new fitness value with the best fitness value. So now we obtain a new fitness value for this VAT, and we already have the best fitness value. So now we will compare whether the new fitness value is better or the best one is better. So in the end, we will display just the optimal solution. So now we are going to compare the new fitness with the best fitness. So we will check whether new fitness is less than best fitness. Then if this condition is true, then best VAT is the new VAT and the best fitness is the new fitness. Then the solution will return best VAT and the best fitness value. Now we will print the solution. So here we will call the function. So here you can see we have number of VAT 20, dimension 5, lower bound minus 10, upper bound is 10, maximum number of iteration 1000. 1000 times this loop will repeat, and after that it will display the best solution. And then the best solution, the best value is displayed by calling the main function that we calculated for this algorithm. Write all the parameters, number of VAT, dimension, lower bound, upper bound, maximum iteration, then print best solution, that is the best underscore solution. Then we will print the best value, that is best underscore value. Now we'll run the solution, and here you can see the result. We obtain here the best solution found, that is its position of that VAT, then the best objective function value we found for that position, this one. Like that, we can run this solution 15 times, 30 times, and each time you will see we are getting a different solution, that is due to the randomness. And here you can see as we are increasing the number of runs, we are getting the better and better fitness value. At one stage, the fitness value will start repeating itself. It means that is the best value we found so far for this objective function. So we can use this algorithm in various fields, including engineering design, image processing, data mining, robotics, to solve complex optimization problems. So that's all about this video. If you have any questions, you can comment below. And thanks for watching this video.